Hello everyone, welcome to the video series part 2. My today's topic is database languages. Database languages are the set of statements that are used to define and manipulate a database. Database languages are used to read, update, and store data in a database. A DBMS has appropriate languages to express database queries and updates. SQL, that is Structured Query Language, is the database language to create database and to perform certain operations on the existing database. The SQL commands are mainly categorized into 5 categories: DQL, DML, DDL, DCL, and TCL. Here is the diagram which categorizes the SQL commands: see DDL, DML, DCL, TCL, and DQL. Create, drop, alter, truncate are the examples of DDL commands. In DML, insert, update, and delete commands are there. In DCL, grant and revoke. In TCL, commit, rollback, and save point. And in DQL, there is only one command, that is select. DDL. It is used to create tables, indexes, sequences, synonyms, views, or specify constraints, etc. in the database. DDL stands for Data Definition Language. It is used to define database structure. Data Definition Language is used to store the information of metadata like the number of tables, their names, indexes, columns in each table, constraints, etc. Basically, it is used to create the skeleton of the database. Examples of DDL commands. Create. Create command is used to create the database or its objects like table, index, sequence, views, or synonyms. Drop. It is used to delete the objects from the database. Alter. It is used to alter the structure of the database. Truncate. It is used to remove all the records permanently from a table, including all the spaces allocated for the records are removed. Comment. It is used to add comments to the data dictionary. Rename. It is used to rename an object existing in the database. DML commands. DML is a language that provides a set of operations to support the basic data manipulation operations on the data held in the databases. It stands for Data Manipulation Language. DML helps in changing the content of the database. The examples of DML consists of insert command, update, and delete command. Insert is used to insert data into a table. Update is used to update existing data within a table. And delete is used to delete records from a database table. Next is DCL. DCL stands for Data Control Language. DCL statements control access to the data and the database using statements such as grant and revoke. A privilege can either be granted to a user with the help of grant statement. The privileges assigned can be select, alter, delete, execute, insert, index, etc. In addition to granting of privileges, we can also revoke, that is taken by using revoke command. Examples of DCL commands are grant and revoke. Grant gives users access privilege to the database, and revoke withdraw users access privilege given by using the grant command. TCL. TCL stands for Transaction Control Language. It is used to run the changes made by the DML statement. TCL commands deal with the transaction within the database. Now, what is a transaction? Transaction is a logical unit of a work. TCL can be used to group into a logical transaction. Examples of TCL commands are commit, rollback, and save point. Commit commits a transaction. Rollback rollbacks a transaction in case of any error occurs, that is, it restores since the last commit. Save point sets a save point within a transaction, for example, save point A, save point B, etc. DQL. DQL stands for Data Query Language. DQL statements are used for performing queries on the database within the schema object. The purpose of DQL statements is to retrieve, store, display specific data from the database. Example of DQL is select command. It is used to retrieve data from the database. Always remember that while using select statement, we never make any changes to the database. It is always used to display data. Thank you so much. In the next series, we will learn DQL in detail.